So I have been looking into calorie deficit and I am ready to go for it. It's where you take in less calories than what you put out to help you lose weight. I am aiming to lose between 8 and 10 pounds a month. So I'm trying to lose 2 pounds a week if possible. And I have PCOS, so this is going to be really hard, but I'm ready to go for it. I have already been doing low carb and I have taken milk out of my diet. So yeah, I'm just gonna see what I can do. Feel free to follow my journey, and yeah, I'm excited. Yeah.
No, I'm not 20 anymore. Don't try to make me feel insecure, 'cause if one thing's for sure, I don't wanna be. I feel so good in my skin.
So I started doing the calorie deficit thing and I had a goal of 8 to 10 pounds a month. I haven't done it the full month. I started like mid-October, so it's been like a little over 2 weeks. Guys, I lost 10 pounds. I'm so excited. Guys, I have PCOS. It's so hard to lose weight and this actually worked. Like, best way to end my month. I'm so happy. Oh, if you have any questions, feel free to follow me and ask. Hi! So my food plan is just counting calories. It's just staying in calorie deficit. So I have my required calories for the day and I just like track everything on my FitnessPal app and just go from there. I mean, with PCOS, the less dairy and gluten you can do, the better. So I still eat cheese and cream cheese and all that, but I have switched from milk to almond milk and that has really helped me. And then gluten, I just try not to go too crazy on it. And I've been trying to do more like homemade foods. So I've been making, like, if I want cookies, I'm making them from scratch, you know? And if I want french fries, I'm cutting up potatoes and I'm air frying them. So I'm trying to have more homemade foods and less processed foods, if that makes sense. But yeah, it's mainly just counting calories. So that's all I've been doing and it works. Hi! So a few of you have asked like how many calories I'm planning on doing for this calorie deficit. And at first when I got on, I saw people doing 1,000 to 1,200 and thought, okay, I'll stick around there. But it wasn't quite enough. And I kept going over and I ended up being like 1,300, 1,400. I'm like, da, da, da. And then someone said to go online and look up calorie deficit calculator. And I did, and it has you type in your age, your height, your weight, and what your desired goal is. And then it tells you how many calories you need to stay where you are, how many calories you need to lose weight, because depending on how active you are. And I just put sedentary because honestly, I'm in Utah and it's getting cold and there's not a guarantee that I'm gonna be exercising every day. I'm gonna be hibernating once the snow starts falling. Look for part two. Okay, part two. So yeah, it tells you how much you need for whether you are like very active or moderately active or sedentary. And like I said, I chose sedentary because I don't know what every day is gonna plan. And so I figured if I exercise that day, like, which I'm hoping I do, but that's just extra calories gone off my body, which is fantastic. And it set me at a goal at 1500 calories. So I decided as long as I don't go over 1500 calories, awesome. So I'm eating what I want. I've had pizza, I've had candy, I've had cookies. I've been making a lot of homemade foods and like, I kind of just plan as I go. Like, if I know I'm going out to eat for the morning and like lunch, I'll have like really light stuff like a salad or some eggs or something that doesn't have very many calories. And then for dinner, if I go to like In-N-Out, that's like 900 calories, but I stay in my calorie deficit.